So we are just looking now at covenant, covenant, right? They're both acceptable here.
No, no. Only covenant.
Oh, no, no. Covenant is at the at, is C. Sorry, yeah, yeah. So this is where you don't have any background information about the people. So non-dealing context. And here it's behaving like rich man.
Ma'am, I think there is some mistake in this. Please show third one. Okay.
So this is where they are. This one now is behaving like which of the covenant. But then shows the one where they're the two are different, Unmese and Kaunsa. You had a no energy as like, was it the first context?
Actually, ma'am, I think there is a mistake in the glossing. Here it should be who, and here it should be which.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, but I'm trying to find the context where Iman say Kavan and Kavane have different values. In your table at the end.
Okay.
Let's
yeah.
look at the table and then come back.
Mm-hmm.
So, context one. Context two is where they differ, right? Kavane and Eman se Kavan, and I want to see if it's the same difference that we have in Hindi or Marathi or whatever between. So that is context two. Let's look at context two. Okay. So here this is shopping trip. So this is the one where you don't have you have a potentially given set, but not an actually given set, right? And in English, we can say which book, but we can't say which of the books. And in Bhojpuri, also you can't say which of the books. And in Hindi also, you can't say unme se kaun si kitab khareedi, because okay. And I think the same in all of the languages for the particular. And you can say kavane here.
Yes, because
can
of.
Can say kaun si in this case?
Here it's all right because of this, I think. Tu kaune kitab ke khareeda?
What is
ke?
Kis
kitab ko khareeda?
Yes.
It's like accusative
marker. Yes.
Suppose you remove that because with inanimate it's necessary.
Tumne kaun si kitab ko khareeda?
Tu kaun kaune kitab khareeda? I think ho jayega nahi.
Balki if adding ke should make it worse, right? Because this is not a context where we have a given. But you, Salman, you were nodding that you can get it okay
yeah.
without the ke, right? And in Hindi, we can get kaun si kitab in this context, right? Same like Marathi for this tea, right? So this is really where the English and the, like it's me, it goes like which N, but not like which of the N. Then where's the difference between, because there's a three-way distinction, and what was the context where Kavan and Kavane were different? Context one. Admi is almost like person, no? Like it's a little bit bleached. So I'm wondering, it's not really like which person. If I think of it as which person, I can say it. Well, I have to think, but I think this is, it's worth thinking about whether you could say, would you say which student, Kavan? If you are in a college setting where, you know, you see some student going in, but you don't know, you know, there are hundreds of students, right? Thousands. Can you say kon student andar gaya? Kavan student?
Yes.
And in Hindi also we can say kon student andar gaya?
But even then
still knew that he was a student. You know that he's a student, yeah. But I'm trying to see whether that is enough, because you can say which man, I could see he's a man, right? He's adult, male. Anyway, this is what I think we might need to tease apart a little bit more, but the three-way distinction is definitely interesting. Four-way, we have four-way as opposed to three-way in English, right? That's what we are.
मैम एक एग्जांपल देना चाहूँ लाइक कौन जूता पहनला तू कौन जूता पहनला एंड इफ देयर इज सम होल इन अ शू सो वी कैन से कौन है जूता में होल है तो या सो हियर वी आर गेटिंग डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन कौन एंड कौन है
सो यू कैन नॉट से कौन जूता में होल
है नहीं कौन है जूता में होल है
It's only left and right, but
then is it that kaone is oblique for
kaone? Kaone is oblique form for kaone.
Like in the from the case that you just said, like
actually that's what I pointed out there, but ma'am,
Salman is not getting it. Doesn't need the K.
One K.
वो सर अभी बात नहीं कर वो कंफ्यूज है सर
इसमें कंफ्यूजन है
वन ए
वन ए
या
अपने के कर ललियारे में गए कैन से आई डोंट नो आई थिंक यू कैन से दैट या
ऑल अ भोजपुरी इंस्टिंक्ट सर
या
तो क्या कंफ्यूजन क्या लेकिन आई एम जस्ट क्यूरियस विद डिसएग्रीमेंट अमंग यू और
सर
you don't like it or you like it?
Actually, we know, like, man is entering.
Suppose you can't tell. Okay, suppose it's too far to tell whether it's a man or a woman.
Then it is okay. Like, someone goes.
No, but suppose you want to know which person, kaun sa aadmi gaya. Aap unhe jante ho kya?
Can I say it be okay if you are seeking more information? Like,
अच्छा लेकिन हम लोग मैं और सलमान ये कहेंगे कि कौन आदमी तब ओके होगा सर के केस में Many both. Both. We can use it with both. Both. K?
K
is not daily, right?
No, humans they are asking. K matlab kaun aur kya mein jo fark hai wo
K aadmi. No, we can't. It's for human only and kya for things. Okay. Ka fir ka. K and ka. K for human, ka for inanimate things. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was
something lower in the animacy, I think like something animate but lower than humans.
I think that is probably going to be the same as, you know, for English who, what, or Hindi, kaun, kya. It's a very subjective kind of hierarchy, right, where you draw the lines.
There is a
question. In Hindi, but we are not sure about that. Kaune
is that it's seeming like consonant, right?
I think if you go to your 4D,
Yes, the next one.
The next one.
When there are different types of dishes, then it will be okay.
It's like English what? The same, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Different type.
Sir.
You want to see the K? where you put a hash.
This one. Who?
Because you already told us in Nigeria.
उस दिन मैम भी डिस्कस कर रही थी आप.
So I think this is the kind of case where people, I also thought that, I forget now, but some people accept like who exactly.
If I put KK, KK then it would be like more than it, more than like one villa has.
But then in this context it should be odd people. You said one and then you're saying
sir, it's saying that
K. You said jital instead of jital, you know, in B.
Milal.
Yeah.
KK Nobel Puraskar Milal. Yeah. Home. Yes.
So why should that make a difference? This whole, you're saying
which
of the Nigerians have what is okay but one is bad?
Maybe with Myanmar, they're getting a sense of who has already won. So there is a list of Nigerians who have won the Nobel Prize.
Right now.
But Jeetna, so win is maybe making it right now. This time who won it?
So Myanmar is also right.
Is it because of the
oblique?
Can be that.
Is it because of the oblique case that she is saying?
No, so the problem is not with oblique here.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
Oh, because Milna will take
oblique. Mila and kisne jeeta.
Kisne jeeta, kisko mila. Usme usse farak pad raha hai.
मेरे हिसाब से तो पड़ रहा था.
कौन
है नाइजीरियन के नोबेल पुरस्कार मिला था? आई कैन से या आई थिंक सलमान. या एमएस से कौने नाइजीरियन के नोबेल पुरस्कार मिला है? देन इट विल बी एमएस से कौने. हियर इट्स एमएस से कौने. In this case, the second B, third B.
So then we should sort out this thing between
oblique. Yes, yes.
It is a context problem.
Yes.
Right? Same as we had with the earlier discussion. More questions? Good. Everybody is in alphabetical order now.
Okay. Next. So we're going to talk about delinking in Assamese and Bangla. So we first just give you a brief picture of what the description of our WHs. These are not all of them, but we came to realize that there are more. And then we'll talk about the context in which you can use a delinked WN and the ones where you can't. Then we'll check for the islands in which you can have a WN delinked one or you may not be able to. And finally, I think we have a part about superiority effects. So that's it. So there's just one distinction, this difference between Assamese and Bangla as far as our dealing WH is concerned. The Assamese one has a structure of WH followed by the classifier and then the noun phrase or whatever. And in Bangla, we always get the WH followed by the noun and then the classifier. And these are all our WH expressions that are not inherently dealing. So we have what, who, and you know, for the various cases, and then when, where, why, how many, and how much, and the classifiers can be any of these. So that's it. And yeah, so we'll just look at, so because we have a classifier, it sort of does something with delinking. It seems to be, at least when we give judgments, it sort of seems to be interacting with it. So let's look at what really happens. So key is what, key n is what n, cone n, which n, and cone enta is which n classifier. So we have three contexts here, and we look at which one works where and which doesn't. So the first is a context where you have no salient set of properties. Tomorrow is Ranin's birthday, and Sham has bought a present for her and tells D about it. So the present can have any property, right? So Sham says, "Ami Ronimer jonno jonmodiner jonno upohar kinlam." So I bought a gift for Ranin's birthday, and you can ask, "What did you buy?" You can ask, "What gift did you buy?" But you can't ask, "Which gift did you buy?" with the classifier. And the next context is a context where you have you have a salient property of being a book. Whatever you're buying has a salient property of being a book, but you don't have a salient set of books. So it's Ranin's birthday tomorrow, and Sham has discussed gift options with D for Ranin's birthday earlier. And Sham says, "I bought a book for Ranin, or I bought the book for Ranin." Actually, I think it should be the okay. So I bought, you know, whatever. I bought a book for Ranin. So so you can't ask what did you buy, because it's already presupposed that you've bought a book. And what book did you buy is fine. Ki boy kinli is fine. But what you can still not ask is what book classifier did you buy. And that's even more obvious from the fact that you can't. You can ask, this is okay. But what you can't do is you can't elide book. Because once you elide book, you don't have a salient set of books that you discussed with D about anymore. Something of that sort. So that happens. And then in context three, you have the salient property of being a book, the stuff that you're buying, and you also have a salient set of books. So the context is, Sham says to D, "I think I will get Ranim a book for her birthday. I'll either get her with nice children or the buried giant. Or if I find the Museum of Innocence, I'll definitely get her that." And the next day, Sham says, "So I bought the book for Ranim." And D says, "What did you buy?" And that's not okay, because obviously you know it's already presupposed that something has been bought. What has been bought? And then ki boy kinli, what book did you buy, is not also not okay. And kon boy ta kinli, which book without the classifier did you buy, is also not okay. And what is perfectly fine is the context where you say kon boy ta kinli with the classifier. So essentially, probably you when you have a salient set of objects, it's okay to use your delinked WH. Then we have, so we tried the context in the handout, and so as you can see, which n CLF, which is the delinked one, is fine with only the context where you have a salient set of, you know, objects. So yeah, the rest are not good. And who and what can be delinked? So you can delink who in someone enters a building, which is just like egress, and what n is not applicable here because what can only go with objects. And then yeah, again you can delink it here. Yes, yeah. So that's the thing. So okay, so we're going to look at the island violations that we have. So we didn't quite find strong islands. I mean, what was strong in English were not strong for us. Or at least that's what it seems like. So we looked at complex noun phrases, WH islands, coordinate structure islands, factives, and then embedding something into it, and then negatives. So so what we found was essentially that we can't move out of WH islands, coordinates, and also factives where your embedded CP has an initial complementizer, the J complementizer. So yeah, we have examples. I'll just discuss the examples.
And this is for extraction or for covert scope?
Covert scope. Okay. Covert scope. We can't do extraction anyway. So I mean, if covert scope doesn't work, extraction just sounds even worse. So yeah. So then what? Yeah. So negatives are. Negatives seem to be weak islands because you can sort of, it's okay to your WHs can have covert scope. I think all of them are arguments, so it's fine. Yeah, when you have adjuncts, it's not good, except for Y, which I think had a so it's a special. So then also weak one is your is the complex noun phrase where you have a non-finite TP as your embedded, whatever is embedded in the CNPC. Everything else is, yeah, so that's the picture, and then we'll just go through the examples. So the first one, the CNPC, which is the one that is bad, is having a correlative, is this a correlative structure? Yeah, correlative kind of structure. So you have J ki sham ke mala diye chhe, sheta rohimer. It's bad. J boita shamke. Okay, so that's the so we've tried it out with both argument WH and with the adjunct. Because you get that sometimes we get it's okay with the argument but not the adjunct, right? So J boita shamke mala kobe dilo sheta rohimer is also bad. Then the other kind of CNPC is with the non-finite TP. So that is okay with arguments, not okay with is okay with which. But not okay with what? What was the only one which it was not okay with? And also okay with adjuncts. Yeah, next. Okay. WH islands are just generally strong. I mean, we can't move out of them. We can't get covert scope anyway. And coordinate structure also. So in the coordinate structure case, we had initially in the previous presentation, at least when we looked through the judgment, we seem to feel that when you question the second coordinate, it's okay, not so bad. But this time when we looked at what Renuka said about how you know how you have to be careful about how you're coordinating and what reading you're actually ending up getting, whether you're actually coordinating the CP and then eliding stuff. So when we looked through that, we found that it was just bad to coordinate things and then move the WH out of it. Yeah, the next one. So factives. So we can't. Our argument, if the WH is an argument and it's in embedded in a factive predicate, then it can't take scope over matrix. So then. Also an adjunct, that's also bad. So factives seem to be strong islands for us. And the J kinds seem to be strong islands for us. The bole, the final complementizer, bole complementizer embedded CPs are okay. You can move out of them. They're fine. You can get covert scope out of them, basically. Yeah.
But not with adjuncts.
Adjuncts are... We had a bit of a problem with adjuncts, but... Yeah, I mean, it depends on the predicate. So Churi Mara was fine because I think we also did a we made it an NV predicate. Churita Mara is what it is. But it wasn't okay with every predicate. It didn't seem okay with me.
So this is the best you. This is a good one.
This is a okay one, yeah. I mean, well, we had a bit of. We had mixed judgment on this. Yeah. Olash,
what would be a possible answer?
পলাশ কি করে চুরিটা করা করলো বলে মেরিয়াম জানে আই মিন ডিড হি গো হোয়াট কাইন্ড অফ
হাউ ক্যান হি ইউজ টু
Without the classifier,
it's far worse than with the classifier. If we say that the classifier sort of helps
because then
you
do it which manner,
in which manner
as opposed to how?
And no, not that. The ta basically is like,
so we are presupposing that
the theft happened, and so there are some sort of possible manners of regularly.
Oh, I see. The how is by itself, and you're saying in which way did the theft
happen?
Negative islands seem for us were weak islands, so we have so these are the example from the adjuncts. So the adjuncts are not that great. Why is, of course, not that great an example. How is bad, and how many was, I don't know, not that great. But we have another instance of how many, which is not kota, which is kotogulo. Yeah, so kotogulo is good. So when we do kotogulo, with gulo is a classifier again, so that's fine. That's good for us.
Gulu is a little bit definite, right?
Yes.
So it's sort of the context where we're talking about
some set of books and
then
how many
is sort of getting linked in that context, and then it appears to be better than
quarter. And the rest of them, which are arguments, are all fine. And also with the model. That's pretty much it. So superiority violations, what we found was that what is okay is to have our delinked WH. So the canonical word order is SOV, and we tried looking at whether it's okay to do OSV, and you questioned both. So then what's okay is to have your object WH be a delinked WH. That's okay. But when you reverse the order, then it's not good. As in, S could be anything here. It could be a delinked or non-delinked, but that could not be. Am I saying it right?
So
yeah.
Your convoy trap A is okay, like your variant of what A, right? 11 is sorry. Because
yes.
Void.
So interestingly, con is this one. So convoy K porche is bad. So, but if you reduplicate the cone, get a distributive reading, it's fine now. You repair it. You can repair it here. So, but it's not again good if you don't distribute K. So when you get a pairless reading, it's fine, which is expected, I suppose. Yeah. So that's about it.
That's all.
In the C, are you looking at both with the classifier, or is it one? What is the difference between the two?
So when you have the classifier here, you can't elide the noun phrase. If you elide the noun phrase, then there's a clash of what you're expecting, because the classifier tells you that you have to pick something which is from a salient set of objects. And once you can only elide something that's already salient, that's already in the context. So you can't really elide that and get the reading.
No, only what did you buy? So this becomes, are you asking what they mean?
what is the difference between two? Aren't they two similar?
Convoita and Quanta.
So this is what this is. Which one did you? Which one did you buy? And this is which book did you buy?
So the but aren't they both Convoita?
No. Actually, what you should might have done is just not add the boy, it would be easier. Because
oh,
if
yeah,
you put the parentheses and the asterisk, that means it's bad whether or not you did a lie, right?
So, the parentheses should be
so you should remove boy completely and say Quanta Kinley is bad. Then
okay.
There wouldn't be this issue.
Okay.
Yeah. So, but you can say Akka, right? I had there were five books. I mean, Akka Kinley, right?
Kinlam.
So you can you in a declarative you can get a delinked reading. I bought one of them, dropping the book, right?
Yes,
sir. Yeah. But it's interesting that.
And while asking.
This is the context where a specific set of books is not given. I see. Yeah. I want to ask, just like your basic thing is, in Bangla, if you didn't have a WH, if you say Boita, it means the book. And then you add the poem or whatever, that seems to be like which of the books, right? So in Assamese, you say the equivalent of Taboi.
Yeah, means we usually add the classifier after the noun, what we call.
In the basic case, in the non like if you wanted to say about the book, what would you say?
My bohikon anilu.
Kitabkon. Kitabkon. Kitab would come first and
kitab
then
would come first
so
and
that
then followed by
they're the same when it comes
to
expressive expressing definiteness in the declarative.
Yeah.
But in the case of a WH
our classifier attaches to the WH word.
And makes, so that's a unexpected difference,
right? I have a question, I mean here. So in Assamese, is it okay if you don't say book? Like using the classifier with the word WH rather than so.
In Assamese,
yes.
In this context.
Like she's saying you cannot say who dash classifier in Bangla. But can you say that in Assamese since your classifier is with the WH?
Means you want me to say kun khon nanili?
Yeah.
No. In this context, it won't be possible. Still, I cannot say. The context has to be that then I can say the kun khon nanili.
So, in the third context, then
you
can book is not at a book is
salient. So, it's still, there's a sense in which it's off the books,
right.
Even if it is morphologically attaching to the left.
And then the second thing is can you ask kon boy? Kingly without the classifier, like just con boy.
No, in Assamese. No.
In Bangla.
Instead of key boy, you ask it con boy.
Con boy without the classifier.
So we can argue, like there's a with key boy, I would expect a type. I mean, I'm open to a type reading and a name of a book. While with the con boy, the type reading is blocked. I can only expect the name of a book. Also, con will not. A key will never go with a delinked context where there's a salient set of books, but cone can be delinked and it naturally lends itself to dealing with the help of ta.
Okay.
But then why is C bad in key in the third context?
Because it has C bad in?
Yeah.
Because the ta is not, because it's a very.
Oh, you need the ta.
Yeah.
We need the ta because there's a contextually salient set of books.
So that's why as in the second way. Where you don't have a contextually salient set of books, can you ask Korn Boy and get the name of the book?
There's some variation in judgments, but we can have a question mark there rather than a star is what we felt. Like Key Boy is the most natural thing because since there's no contextually salient set of books, you can answer if it's a type of book or a specific name, so it goes better with the context than.
You
wouldn't give genres if it is in a second context. But again, there's a
sort of
given depends on speaker judgments vary there a little bit.
So is there clear case with convoy, no ka? convoy Kinley is really good. In
which context?
No, in any context, like where would I really be able to say convoy?
It can pass only in the second context. It's blocked in both, like completely blocked. Like even in the first one, phone upohar kingly is kind of bad because there is no there's a property of being a book and then you're picking out objects that denote that of that property. But with upohar there's like if we consider common nouns, they are all different, like no contextually salient property is at issue there. So
I mean, you haven't yet specified that what the
kind
is,
of, yeah.
What
so
property.
Here you have Pono Karta, and that's bad.
Yes.
There wasn't a particular set of.
Even
Pono
Upohar
is bad.
Also
there.
Bad. Also bad there.
Okay.
Pono Upohar is also bad.
Oh, we haven't put that.
Put that here.
I'm still not really aware. I could use Pono Upohar or Pono Kitab, Pono Boy, without the ta.
Second set from where. We have a salient property there, but not say contextually salient objects with that property.
And then you can use.
Then you can. It has one more layer of specificity than key, and with ta it's very specific. I'm not sure if I'm using the right terminology, but if we have like three sets, one of all objects, then one of books, and within it a set of five books, then four with ta would only be in the lowest. And cone can pass on without ta can only sort of arguably pass in the middle set.
More questions? Okay. Thank you, really. I was a little bit worried that I'm letting you, without having a enough details, but this was my hope that we would get some systematicity and some new information, and I think you've definitely done that, right? So lunch, and then
we'll come back by 2:30. We'll start by 2:30.
Has everyone taken a handout?
No.
This
room is going to be locked, right?
Yes.